In this video, I will teach you how to install Python libraries into Visual Studio Code on a Mac. This is a compilation video in which I demonstrate how to install various Python libraries through examples, which you can then use to install any Python library you may need. I hope you enjoy the video. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about how to install matplotlib in Visual Studio Code on a Mac. If you do not have Visual Studio Code installed yet on your Mac, click on the video in the top right-hand corner of your screen now or in the description down below to quickly install Visual Studio Code on your Mac. So, let's get right into this tutorial. Let's begin by opening up Visual Studio Code by hitting Command and Space, searching Visual Studio Code, and hitting Enter. Now, let's go on our desktop and create a brand new folder that we can use for our matplotlib project. So, I'm just going to call it such. Inside Visual Studio Code, let's open our matplotlib project. We need a Python file to import our matplotlib into, right? So, let's create a new file through this button here and name it main.py. We call it main because this is going to be our main script. The py indicates that we are using a Python file. Now, let's go up to View and open our terminal window. As you can see, we are indeed inside our newly created folder on our desktop based on this directory here. In order to import libraries inside our folder, we need to first create a Python virtual environment. To accomplish this, let's head down to our terminal and type Python 3.9, or whatever version of Python you are working with, -m venv, and then the name of your virtual environment, which I will just call Study Session. Now, if you go back to File Explorer on Visual Studio Code, you can see our virtual environment is now here. Next, let's first activate our virtual environment, so that our terminal knows that we only want to work within this virtual environment. To do this, we type source, and then the activate file that was created with our virtual environment. For us on Macs, this is source, your virtual environment name, bin activate. Now, you can see that we are working within our virtual environment because of the parentheses name here on the left of our terminal line. Let's also update pip. To update pip, let's type pip install --- upgrade pip, and we will install the latest version of pip. We do this just in case there are any errors that could occur down the line. To install matplotlib to our virtual environment, let's type pip install matplotlib, and you should see a download begin like so. To validate this, let's write the following sample code to ensure matplotlib is working within our virtual environment correctly. When we hit run, a little graph appears here, which means that it is working correctly. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about how to install Tinker in Visual Studio Code on a Mac. If you do not have Visual Studio Code installed yet on your Mac, click on the video in the top right-hand corner of your screen now, or in the description down below to quickly install Visual Studio Code on your Mac. So let's get right into this tutorial. Let's begin by opening up Visual Studio Code by hitting Command and Space, searching Visual Studio Code, and hitting Enter. Now, let's go to our desktop and create a brand new folder that we will use for our Tinker project. So, I'm going to call it such. Now, inside Visual Studio Code, let's open up our Tinker project. Now, we need a Python file to import Tinker into, right? So, let's create a new file through this button here and name it main.py. This will be our main script that we add all our Tinker code to in the project. And the py indicating that we are using a Python file. Let's go up to View and open up our terminal window like so. As you can see, we are indeed inside our newly created folder on our desktop based on this directory here. So, in order to import libraries inside our folder, we need to create a Python virtual environment. To accomplish this, let's head down to our terminal and type Python 3.9, or whatever version of Python you are working with, -m venv, and then the name of your virtual environment. But I'm just going to call it study session. Now, if you go back to our file explorer on Visual Studio Code, you can see our virtual environment is now here. Let's first activate our virtual environment so that our terminal knows we only want to work within this environment. So, type source, and then we need to access the activate file that was created with our virtual environment. To do that, we type source, study session, or the name of your virtual environment, bin, and activate. Now, you can see we are working with our virtual environment because of the parentheses names on the left of our terminal line. Now, Tinker is actually a part of the standard Python library. Therefore, there is nothing we need to do other than import it into our main Python file, which we can do by typing import tinker. Then, to validate that Tinker is working within our new virtual environment, let's type the following bit of sample code. As you can see, this bit of sample code creates a small pop-up window, and this validates that Tinker was installed correctly. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how to install and get started with Tinker on Visual Studio Code on a Mac. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about how to install SciPy in Visual Studio Code on a Mac. If you do not have Visual Studio Code installed yet on your Mac, click the video in the top right-hand corner of your screen now, or in the description down below to quickly install it on your Mac. So, let's get right into this tutorial. Let's begin by opening up Visual Studio Code by hitting Command and Space, searching Visual Studio Code, and hitting Enter. Now, let's go on our desktop and create a brand new folder that we will use for our SciPy project. So I'm just going to call it such. Inside Visual Studio Code, let's open our SciPy project. Now, we need a Python file to import SciPy into, right? So, let's create a new file through this button here and name it main.py. The py indicates that we are creating a Python file. Now, let's go up to our view options here and open our terminal window like so. As you can see, we are indeed inside our newly created folder on our desktop based on this directory here. So, in order to import libraries inside our folder, we need to create a Python virtual environment. To accomplish this, let's head down to our terminal and type Python 3.9, or whatever version of Python you are working with, -m, venv, and then whatever the name of the virtual environment you want to create is, but I'm just going to call mine Study Session. Now, if we go back to our file explorer on Visual Studio Code, you can see our virtual environment is now here. Let's first activate our virtual environment such that our terminal knows that we only want to work within this newly created virtual environment. So, we type source, and then we find the activate file that was created within our virtual environment. So, for me, this is source, study session, bin, and activate. Now, you can see that we are working within our virtual environment because of the parenthesis names here on the left of our terminal line. Next, let's upgrade our pip. To upgrade pip, let's type pip install --- upgrade pip, and we will install the latest version of pip. Now, to install SciPy to our virtual environment, let's type pip install SciPy, and you should see a download begin like so. To validate this, let's write the following simple code that solves for the roots of a quadratic function to ensure that SciPy is now working within our virtual environment. We hit run and we are presented with the roots of our function, which means SciPy is now working. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to talk about how to install NumPy in Visual Studio Code on a Mac. If you do not have Visual Studio Code installed yet on a Mac, Click the video in the top right-hand corner of your screen now, or in the description down below, to quickly install Visual Studio Code on your Mac. So, let's get right into this tutorial. Let's begin by opening up Visual Studio Code by hitting Command and Space, searching Visual Studio Code and hitting Enter. Now, let's go on our desktop and create a brand new folder. This will be used for our NumPy project, so I'm going to call it such. Now, inside Visual Studio Code, let's open our NumPy project. Now, we need a Python file to import NumPy into, right? So, let's create a new file through this button here and name it main.py. This will be our main script for the project. And also, the py is indicating that we are creating a Python file. Now, let's go up to View and open our terminal window here. As you can see, we are indeed inside our newly created folder on our desktop based on this directory here. So, in order to import libraries into our folder, we first need to create a Python virtual environment. To accomplish this, let's head down to our terminal and type Python 3.9, or whatever version of Python you are currently working with, -m, venv, and then the name of your virtual environment, which I will call Study Session. Now, if we go back to the File Explorer on Visual Studio Code, you can see our virtual environment is now here. So, let's first activate our virtual environment so that our terminal knows that we only want to work within this environment. To do this, type source and then the activate file that was created with our virtual environment. Source, study session, bin, activate. Now, you can see we are working within our virtual environment because of these parentheses names here on the left of our terminal line. To upgrade pip, let's type pip install dash dash upgrade pip. And we will install the latest version of pip. Now, to install NumPy to our virtual environment, let's type pip install NumPy, and you should see a download begin like so. To validate this, let's write the following simple code that creates a simple matrix to ensure that NumPy is working within your virtual environment correctly. When we hit run, we are presented with our matrix here, which means NumPy is now working. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how to install NumPy into Visual Studio Code on a Mac. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.